back it up, you got it, you got it.
Hello YouTube, and welcome to a brand new video. Today we're doing a full car tour, exterior, interior, features of this Mercedes-Benz GLS. It is fully loaded and has beautiful white quilted seats, white pearl exterior. So I wanted to take you guys along to show you it, let you enjoy the vehicle, and let's just get right into it. But I did want to throw in, the car did just get detailed. It does not always look like this. So there's your little disclaimer. I do keep it super clean and minimalistic. I don't keep things in the door panels. I don't keep trash in it. However, it did just need like a light vacuum and then of course an exterior wash. So it looks perfection right now. However, occasionally it does look a little bit dirty.
This is the front of the outside of the vehicle. It does have the illuminating star. So this illuminates at night along with the projector headlights. It does have these air vents that go to the bonnet hood of the car to give more air intake, since it does. I'd say if we turn around, it does have aluminum rims, but we're gonna get those changed to black rims and get a much larger. I believe these are 22s and we'll probably end up putting 24s on. It does have this running board that does illuminate when you open and unlock the car. The mirrors do fold in, and then it looks like this going around. It's not fully tinted, so we still are gonna get that. But this is the side of the car. The back of the car has had some work done. We got the tailgate lights tinted, and then we ordered a custom vanity plate that says Lux. And then we're gonna get this chrome bar and the emblem blacked out, so it'll match and the lights will look like they go all the way across with the black. The back is super tinted, and so is the third brake light. This is what the back looks like. And the trunk is automatic, so whether from the key or the driver's side, it can open and close. This is this side of the car. It just got washed. It is a pearl white exterior color and finish, which is absolutely beautiful, especially with the all black and when we get the new rims. We unlock it with the key fob. The mirrors stay closed until you open the door, but it does have that illuminating light, and also the running boards illuminate, if you can see that. There's also the star projector that glows on the floor at night, and this Mercedes-Benz floor lamp, which obviously these things look way better at night. It's hard to show during the daytime, so I'll get footage of that. If you open the door, this is what the door panel looks like. It's very beautiful. We opted for the black wood trim. It's a black veneer because we don't like wood. And then it's got the seat adjusters with the memory settings. It's got white quilted interior, which was an absolute must. And it has black stitching that matches cohesively throughout. That is the rear button that you can use to open the trunk, and then the power folding mirrors, and then to adjust the mirrors, the window locks, and opening. So this is what the interior looks like. It does still have the plastic on the floor mats because the car just got detailed, but these are the seats. They're absolutely beautiful. They're the designo Napa leather, so they're the highest quality Mercedes leather. It's white quilted diamond stitched, and then also has black piping details. And if you can kind of see, it's illuminating the ambient lighting, which is all blue, but it can change to orange or white or ice. Crystal blue, but I'll have to show that at night as well. The driver's seat of this car is just so luxurious with the heated and cooled seats and then massaging. It has a four-spoke steering wheel with multimedia controls. Also shows the either navigation, music, or speedometer on this center screen. Goes up to 160 miles per hour, and then the torque. On this side, you can see the white stitching, all leather, and then suede. So it's all handcrafted materials. That just says Mercedes-Benz Preferred Owners Program. That sticker on the outside, you can see the air vents. And then it has this shift knob, so you can go into drive, reverse, or park by pressing that. Go into like the settings. You can see there's the navigation, audio, then you have telephone, And then you have like assistance warning. So this car has blind spot assistance, which obviously you can see on the mirrors. And then also has distance warning. So that's what that thing does if you get too close. Assistance graphic is when you go, if you're starting to steer out of your lane, the attention assist will shake the steering wheel and make a beep beep chime to let you know that you need to stay in your lane. Unless you have the turn signal on like this and then try and swerve, then it will not do that. But if you just are driving straight and rear from the path, then it will auto correct that for you. And you just have tire pressure, maintenance notice, which obviously this car is up to date. And then you have settings. So you have the instrument cluster, which shows in miles. You have the lighting, so the daytime running lights. Also, you have ambient lighting, which you can change all the colors, the levels, and then the colors. You can also go to vehicle if you want acoustic door locks and automatic door locks. And then convenience, you have easy entry, which lifts the steering wheel up when you're driving. And then seatbelt adjustments, which actually tightens when you turn it on.
I'm gonna show you guys what the seatbelts do. So when you click it and then let it go, it'll auto pull back and tighten for you, giving you a really snug feeling. And the safety features on this car are plentiful. This car was optioned out with basically every single option there is. So
it also illuminates with both the floor puddle lights and the door running board. This door looks the same, and honestly, most Mercedes don't come with the second door having the memory seats and power adjusting on the door. It's usually below, however, that has the lumbar support. And so everything's on this door and looks very cohesive with the driver's door. In here, it's just absolutely beautiful. It has this wood inlay that says designo leather, and then even the upper dashboard is a nice soft designo leather with white stitching.
So I'm trying to see, I'll show you guys at night, but you can see right now we have it on ice glacier blue, and it's gonna illuminate this whole board and then even the door panels below the designo sign. So above the car, it does have, of course, a sunroof, which goes all the way back, and then it does have micro Napa suede headlining. So whether it be the visors or the entire way back is micro suede and ultra plush and soft. Even the side panels of the door for the B pillar and C pillar back there.
This is the lights for the whole car to turn them off if you open the door. The reading lights, and then it does have a fleece lined place to put your sunglasses. It has the SOS button and Mercedes maintenance and information that will pop up on the screen. This thing, which I didn't know what it was, it actually has three bars that'll illuminate as you get closer to something on the right side or left side. So it'll start beeping and chiming, and then it'll go beep, 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 and light up bars for how close you are. This is the command screen, which can play movies. And then this car does come with heated seats, which are obviously indicated by the red, cooled seats indicated by the blue. And then it does have self-parking, so you can turn this off. And then the traction control, here's the AC command system. So if you just turn it on, it'll illuminate by the bars and have all of these functions. Moving down, you have just a little storage area. And then in this thing, you have the cup holders, which can be cooled or heated, and it actually changed the lights, if you can see. So it glows red to let you know it's gonna keep your coffee hot, or like your smoothie cool by the blue. And then if you turn it off, it just goes orange. And then it also has a little ashtray and lightning adapter, which there's a cover for this. It also has this net pocket, and even this is all leather in the whole car. Glove box by lifting this up, and then it opens. It has a mini storage, and then just the larger storage. Here we have the settings to lift or raise the car, and that goes onto this screen. And then from there, you can either height or lower the car. This controls the command screen as well if you didn't want to press these functions or the ones on the steering wheel. The back, again, the projector lights, which you can see much better now. And then these are just the quilted doors. Again, it has a speaker, and then the door openers. The rear do have television screens, so both the headphones for both sides and the remotes for both sides are back here. So if you just press this remote, you can do command system left or right and just turn it on. It'll illuminate whatever movie is playing, which right now is Peppa Pig. Same thing goes for the right, so as long as the right's on, it'll turn the right on, and then it'll illuminate with that Mercedes-Benz symbol until the movie starts playing. Down here with the headphones, and you have rear seat climate control, which does a lot of functions. In addition, this is where the DVD insert disc is. You can eject it and then put it in there. You can have up to 3 DVDs in here, I believe. And then it
seats also adjust whether you want them folded back in a laying position or up.
Simply clicking this button, it'll fully power fold down for you and lift up to get into the rear seats. And then the left side does it as well. So buttons on the side if you wanted to do it, or lift the third row up. So the large rear door panels also have sun visors to give some shade to the rear passengers. They just open and close by doing this. So when you open the rear of the vehicle by holding the key fob, it'll open. And this is what the back looks like. It is a 3-row SUV because it is the largest Mercedes-Benz sedan or SUV that they make. It's has power folding third row seat. So this is the left and this is the right. So if you just click them out like that, they will pop up in addition to that one. And it becomes third row, 7 seat capabilities. These are what these seats look like back here. And they do have their own cup holders on each side. And then you can also power adjust them down. We keep them down for more storage space, even though it does have quite a bit of storage space. So it has the spare tire under this flap with a few tools, but it does come with Mercedes-Benz roadside assistance if you needed that as well. The tailgate lights look when they are turned on. They still come through the tailgate light tint perfectly, and so there's no visibility issue, but you can just see the white on white car with just a little bit of black accents and then some shiny chrome is actually such a vibe.
Yeah, guys, that was the whole interior and exterior and review of the car. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. I enjoyed filming this per the usual. I just love doing car tours. I love watching car tours. And this car is definitely top line, top grade. And I can't wait for you guys to come on the journey with me to keep modifying cars because, you know, I love myself some new rims, a good tint job, blacking out chrome delete, whatever you call it. It's just all super fun to me. So I will show you guys a few of the features of the car at night with all the ambient lighting and the logos that project everywhere. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. You super enjoyed the car. Come with me and keep seeing the journey of the car transformation. Also, if you have any comments, leave them down below and I'll try and get back to them in response. If you could just hit the red subscribe button so you can see more content, more interactions and things that are happening in my life, whether it be getting new cars, shopping, adventures, travel. And till next time, guys, bye.